Hey guys and welcome back to Sweviver. Today I'll show you something you probably haven't seen on YouTube before. We will take a closer look through the lenses on how the VR racing simulator Project Cars 2 looks with different field of view modes, such as the 3 wide field of view modes on the Pimax 5K Plus headset compared to a narrow field of view on the Samsung Odyssey VR headset. Basically 170, 150, 125 degrees field of view versus 110 degrees field of view. The question here is, does a wide field of view really matter for VR racing simulators? And well, yes, it's up to you to decide, of course, but I hope this video can give you a better idea, especially if you have never tried any wide field of view headset. Before we start off, a big thanks to all my lovely Patreon supporters and a special thanks to my 3 official sponsors on Patreon, Commander Darklight, Art Armin and VR Ambassador. So let's just jump right into it. I want to show you what wide field of view does for a racing simulator in virtual reality by giving you a bunch of examples of through the lens videos I have taken with a dual camera setup, one camera for each lens of course. The cameras are wide angle action cameras capable of capturing the entire horizontal field of view of each eye on both the Pimax headset and the Samsung Odyssey headset. Do not mind the image quality here. What you see here are through the lens videos which are very difficult to record, so the image quality is much worse here than it actually looks in VR, both on the Odyssey and the Pimax headset. Also, the cameras are not fully identical and one of them, which is slightly cheaper, catches more gad rays than the other camera. The different pixel matrix of the headsets also catches differently by the cameras, so let's just overlook that for today. The brightness and colors could also differ a bit, but please just skip the image quality entirely for this time. The important thing here is the field of view and what you're actually seeing in your viewable area. First, let's have a look at the Samsung Odyssey running Project Cars 2 VR with approximately 100 to 110 degrees field of view horizontally. While recording all this with two cameras, the headset was completely still, of course, looking straight forward from a normal sitting position in the McLaren car. As you probably noticed already, you can barely see the left mirror of your car using the Samsung Odyssey headset. Only half of the mirror is indeed in your viewable area, and even if it's hard to see it here in this video, the lower sweet spot on the Odyssey makes the mirror a bit more blurry, at least if you're looking straight ahead without moving your head to the left. The sweet spot or the center area of the view, which is fully sharp, is a bit limited on the Odyssey, even if it is larger than many other headsets such as the Vive Pro, the Oculus Rift, and even the HP Reverb as an example. The right mirror of your car is of course not possible to see here, as it's way beyond your view to the right side, and not even the A-pillar on the right side of your car is seen here. Now let's compare the same scene in Project Cars 2 VR on the Pimax 5K Plus with large field of view of 170 degrees horizontally. Immediately you can see that the left mirror of your McLaren is fully visible in your view, and not only visible but also fully sharp, just as the center part of your view. This means you do not need to move your head to the left to look at the mirror. You can just quickly move your eyes instead and see a sharp mirror on your left side. The right side mirror is also fully visible by just looking straight ahead, even if it's not fully sharp due to some light blurriness in the peripheral vision. I would say it's still fully possible to look at the right mirror and distinguish your opponent cars without moving your head at all. Now let's merge the left and right images together to create one big view, which you're actually seeing in total with both of your eyes with a stereoscopic 3D vision. With an 170 degrees field of view, you have the majority of your eye's peripheral view filled up with the in-game view, giving you the freedom to see opponents driving next to you, which is impossible with a narrow 110 degrees field of view headset. Now, when I'm going back to the Samsung Odyssey recordings here, you probably understand what I mean. You don't see the opponent cars until they have already passed you, which could make things a little bit more difficult in a competitive race. On the Pimax headset, you see your opponent car when it's driving next to you, or even slightly before when he's approaching you from the back. Now also, let's have a look at all the three different field of view modes of the Pimax 5K Plus headset compared to the Samsung Odyssey. All the current wide field of view Pimax headsets has three different field of view modes. A large field of view of approximately 170 degrees horizontally, a normal field of view of around 150 degrees, and a small field of view of around 125 degrees horizontally. The large field of view and normal field of view doesn't differ that much, as it's basically 10 degrees of field of view more or less on each side in your peripheral vision. The large field of view helps you to see the right mirror a little bit better, as the normal field of view only shows it partially, at least when driving a McLaren car in Project Cars 2. Also, you see slightly more of the track on each side, of course. Now let's compare the large field of view to the small field of view. Now it's easy to see that the small field of view, which is 125 degrees horizontally, starts to limit your sight a lot. It's not bad at all, but it's indeed a big difference. Especially while seeing all this in VR, the difference is more clear than you're actually seeing in this video. Normal field of view versus small field of view also clearly shows a difference, despite the fact that it's only around 25 or 30 degrees more in total on the normal field of view compared to the small field of view. Now lastly, let's do a few more comparisons with the large field of view, the normal and small field of view, together with the Samsung Odyssey 110 degrees field of view. Remember that the small field of view of Pimax is only around 125 degrees, that's roughly 15 or 20 degrees more than the Samsung Odyssey. So each side gives you maybe only between 7 to 5 degrees more, and still such a huge difference. So basically, the wide field of view gives you a much better awareness of what's happening on the track while driving. I guess the real VR racing simulator fanatics do not move their head much at all, just like in real life, whereas in real life the racing drivers cannot move their head much because of the strong G-forces, especially with fast cars. So I think the wide field of view really gives you an advantage here, especially if you take your racing session seriously. Now we're gonna focus on the perceived speed or velocity of your car. Let's have a look at the Pimax versus Samsung Odyssey side by side or over and under. The Pimax with 170 degrees field of view is in the top, while the Odyssey, which is 110 degrees of field of view, is in the bottom side. Now please tell me, do you see the difference in the perceived sense of speed? In my opinion, the car feels like it's driving much faster on the Pimax. You get a higher sense of speed because you see more of the peripheral view, or the left or right side view of course. Everything in the environment, such as the trees, the buildings, fences that passes you by in the peripherals, gives you a better sense of speed because the peripheral view is the most important factor that gives you the feeling of speed. You can actually feel how fast everything is moving next to you, which is impossible on a narrow field of view headset simply because the sides are cut off from your viewable area. Another thing that I think makes a wide field of view superior is the fact that it increases the immersion in VR. It actually feels like you're sitting in that car driving instead of looking through a scuba mask with black blinders. I know, the racing drivers in real life does indeed wear a helmet that somehow limits the view, especially the vertical field of view, but the horizontal field of view is still very wide wearing a helmet, so having a wide field of view in racing simulators is definitely not unrealistic. Well, I'm not a racing driver, but I have done some go-kart races in my life, and I would say that the field of view through a helmet is very close to the field of view in a Pimax headset. So if we summarize this up, what are the benefits of a wide field of view? Well, there are probably many factors for this, but for me it's mainly four things. First, the immersion of actually feeling that you're sitting in that car for real. Secondly, the awareness, or the fact that you can see much more of the track and your opponent in your peripherals, and you get more aware of what's happening on the track. The third factor is comfort, as you don't need to move your head at all during the race and still see all your mirrors by just moving your eyes. And lastly, the sense sense of speed. You really feel the velocity using a wide field of view headset because your peripheral view helps you to perceive the actual speed or acceleration. Now, this was just a part one video of a new series that I will follow up, and I will try more simulators and games with those different field of view modes. And guys, what do you think about the difference between all the field of view modes in VR? Let me know in the comments down here below. Thank you so much for watching, everyone, and please subscribe to my channel for more geeky VR related videos coming up. If you appreciate my content, please join my Patreon, I would really appreciate that. And lastly, a big thanks to all my lovely Patreon supporters, including my official sponsors, Commander Darklight, Art Armin, and VR Ambassador. See you in the next one, guys. Cheers!